championship fight between the Korean Superboy, Doo Ho Choi, and Glover Teixeira. Well, for a long time, he's been mentioned with the baddest men on the planet. For a long time, though, the title fight eluded him. Not anymore. Here he is, the number one heavyweight contender, finally making this walk and cracking a smile. He's waited a long time for this. He's not expecting a 25-minute war. He believes he has the power and the skills to get this thing done quickly. I guess we'll find out. Well, a lot of people think it's the most significant title in combat sports. No argument from me. Baddest man on the planet, UFC heavyweight champion. There he is in the flesh. What an absolute monster. What a title reign it has been. But a serious challenge in front of him here tonight. When this man became the heavyweight champion, a lot of people thought that this challenger was the one who would wrest the belt away. Now the fight is here. We'll see if we get a new champion or if this man continues one of the greatest heavyweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. Choi is 29, Teixeira is 40. He weighed in at 205 pounds. He will have a 6-inch reach advantage. The veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 33 wins, 9 losses.
He stands 6'2" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Presenting the challenger, Glover Teixeira. And now it is the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 14 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw.
He stands 5'10" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, fighting out of Busan, South Korea. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the Korean Superboy, Doo Ho Choi.
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, come back to your corners, come out fighting.
So the fight is underway. We will see how it plays out. It's a pick'em fight, of course, in Las Vegas, and really hard to think of a weakness that we have seen on film from either guys in their UFC careers.
I feel like both of these guys are the top of the food chain. They're the best of the best that we can put inside the Octagon. They are so well-rounded. They have every skill, and that is going to be on display tonight in this key matchup.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. All right, so there's the early takedown. He told us on Thursday he didn't necessarily see a path to victory if he couldn't get takedowns. That is certainly a good sign.
Right away, he got the takedown. I don't believe they could have imagined that it would work so well so early. Great job.
Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Choi. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Starting to see some of the damage cut underneath that right eye. Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked.
Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Just misses there with the left. Just over 3 minutes now to go.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, he leads with a power right hand there, DC. That'll work.
Really sat down on that right hand. Good punch.
Oh, huge block.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Nicely done defensively to avoid the double leg takedown there. Choi's attempt there is blocked by the opponent. Throws a big right hand, but doesn't find its home. Strike there by Teixeira. Overhand block there by Choi. A little single collar tie there. 26 total strikes have now landed for Glover Teixeira. Left-right combo is good. Lifts on the straight right hand. Saw us referencing the tail of the tape, DC. He's got the reach advantage and certainly made good use of it there in landing that jab. Whiffs on the right hand. Effective punch there by Teixeira. Again, he's looking for that left. It's not there. Nice job landing the double jab there, DC.
I mean, you are definitely pressing that one. You love that one, don't you? You love that jab.
And they separate. Timely defense there. Huge block for him. Choi's cut is only getting worse, making a nice donation to the canvas tonight.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this?
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Oh, straight right.
Gotta check these low leg kicks.
That is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talks to your toughness.
Oh, straight right.
Jab hurt him a little bit.
So he stuffs another takedown there. He talked to us about how hard this training camp was in terms of the defensive wrestling, but he certainly put in the right work.
He did a great job of recognizing the threat, understanding that he could not allow his opponent to get to his hips. He never allows his opponent to get to his hips. And because of that, he's been safe.
All right, so there's the horn. That means it's the end of the round, and a lot of good offensive wrestling work from him over those previous 5 minutes.
I mean, great offensive wrestling. Every time he changed levels and got to his opponent's legs, he was able to secure the takedown. Let's see what type of fatigue his opponent will carry into the next round.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. A stunner there with the head strike midway through. Nearly got him out of there for good.
Almost got him out of there. He hurt him badly. He had his opponent hurt real bad. Now his opponent's walking back to his corner. Everybody looks confused. They don't know what they're supposed to do to try to change the way that this fight is going. Ooh, what a punch.
And he's looking for that left hand, just missed.
Beautiful body kick land right under the elbow.
Lands a glancing right hand upstairs.
Ooh, another shot to the head.
There is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. So the celebration is on for the UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the baddest man on the planet, and your winner, yes, by knockout here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta is going to stop this contest at 34 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, the Korean Superboy, Doo-Ha-Choi.
All right, so heavyweight title retained is the headline inside this arena here tonight. Congratulations to the